Fame for you? Oh, I mean, it's amazing. Not something I would ever thought about happening, I guess, until I got the call. But yeah, it's a huge honor. I think it makes it even more special to go with Nuge, too. I grew up with him, known him and his family forever, so I think it works out perfectly. The time and everything about it. My kids get to come and everything, so it's going to be a great weekend.
You said it's not something you would have thought of, but take us back to you coming out of high school. What were your expectations coming to Ohio State, and what did you hope to accomplish here?
I didn't have any expectations, to be honest with you. My whole high school life was just trying to get a scholarship to Ohio State, trying to get offered. So then once I committed, I was like, all right, now what? What do I do now? But I think once I got here, I guess I was, pretty young, naive, understood, like, just be quiet and try to work, try to get on the field somehow. And luckily I was my freshman year and just kind of ran from there. But I also, like, once I got there, I think I learned real quick from the upperclassmen that what it was like to be a college player, what it took, how to be a true pro even at the college level. Like, those guys did it the right way, and I learned so much from them. So I owe a bunch to them. I think I learned real quickly what it was like and what was needed if you wanted to compete at a high level.
Who were a few of those guys?
Oh, man, Mike Doss, Donnie Nicky, Craig Krenzel was there, Robert Reynolds, Tim Anderson. There's a million of them. Like, there's so many of those guys. I would just sit back and watch them in practice, in the weight room, everywhere, and try to be like them, really.
Is that the record straight? Were you a three that became a four before you arrived here in terms of star?
Oh, gosh. The whole recruiting thing. Probably a zero. I don't know. Did they have stars back then when I was coming out?
Oh, yeah.
And would you have been recruited today?
No, probably not. Probably you're not. I probably wouldn't have, especially. Well, I snuck in. I got offered. I came out for camp. Got offered going into my senior year right before in the summer, and then got hurt the first game of my senior year. Tore my PCL. Luckily, they stuck with me. Still kept a scholarship. But I don't know how it would work out now. It's so different how the college recruiting is. So yeah, I have no idea. Probably not. I guess the timing worked out well.
Were you a chip on the shoulder guy at all, or not really?
No, I don't think I paid enough. I don't think I was smart enough to have a chip on my shoulder. I didn't understand what that meant. I think everyone's kind of motivated by different things. I never really wanted to be. I never really was trying to prove people wrong. I had two older brothers, so I remember them even telling me, like, no, who cares? Prove people right. Prove Coach Tressel right. And those guys that offered you, they think you deserve to be there for a reason. So prove them right. Don't waste time and waste energy trying to prove people wrong. And I kind of always stuck with that through my career.
You mentioned Ohio State was the dream. Was the NFL also something you hoped for?
Yeah, I mean, it was a dream. But even when I was at Ohio State, it wasn't. I didn't think about it too much. I mean, I really didn't think it was a possibility until probably after my junior year sometime. And the only reason I thought that, I remember someone asked me if I was coming out early. And I was on a flight to Vegas for my 21st birthday. I'm like, no, I'm coming back to school. I'll be there. Maybe after my junior year. But no, even during my senior year, I wasn't too focused on it or worried about it. I knew, like, yeah, this is, if everything works out, hopefully I get drafted. That was the plan. That'd be awesome. But I mean, I still stayed in school and was still in school when I got drafted and everything and wanted to finish. So it was a little different time, too. I think it set up everything that Coach Tressel did and all the coaches here set me up perfectly to play at the next level.
So, like, coming in with that huge class that was mostly Ohioans, is kind of an outlier if you look at how many great Ohio prospects there were that year. What was it like coming in with that?
It was awesome. Our class was so good, top to bottom. Like, there's so many big-time Ohio players, too, that year. And then the others sprinkled in from around the country were really, really good. But I feel like we were pretty tight from the beginning. When we came in, played with some of them in, like, North-South game, Big 33, and then got to see a lot of those guys, too, at different, not recruiting things, but different events they've had for high school guys, not just Ohio State people, but we always kind of stuck together. I remember when we would go to those events, the Ohio State guys that were committed would. But coming in from day one, we knew, we have a huge class and we have a great coach, but we have to do something to prove that we deserve to be here. And I think guys felt that. Like, everyone was really motivated from the beginning and kind of fed off each other. So it was a special class. I mean, there's so many good players there and good guys that I still talk to now.
What's your earliest Mike Nugent memory?
My earliest Mike Nugent memory Wow. Probably playing basketball in our driveway, my house. His brother Kev, who's my age, Mike's 1 year older than me. I don't know what age it would have been, 6, 7 years old, but I always tell people Nuge is a really good athlete. Nuge played quarterback and running back, so he can play. He's not just a kicker, he's an athlete too. So I remember Nuge from way back in the day, playing every sport and playing running back, quarterback, and he just happened to be a good kicker too at the time. We didn't know it would turn into his career and how good it was here too. We had no idea, but I knew how good he was everything else.
It did, and he probably committed to Ohio State well before you, I assume.
Yeah, he hosted me on my official visit then too. So yeah, when he got offered and committed, it was awesome to see another Centerville guy, a guy that I played with, grew up with, going to Ohio State. So when I committed, I was excited. He hosted me on my official visit, and then actually when I came up, so I graduated high school and came up for the summer to work out, I stayed at Nuge's apartment too. So he was very helpful. I just gave him gave him a ride here tonight. So still helping him out, yeah.
How'd you find out about this?
I got a call from Ernie at Petropolis. He left me a few messages. I'm not the best at picking up my phone, I guess. And I always feel bad for them with four kids yelling in the background. I don't want to make them upset. I'm like, hey, man, it's not going to be a fun phone call. You don't just text me. And he left me a message, said, hey, just call me. I need to talk to you. It's something important. And then I had no idea what it was. And he told me it was for this. So I thought, oh, that's amazing. It's not definitely not what I thought I was getting a call from or for. But, yeah, I was excited. And then told my wife and my parents and everything. They were very excited. I think that's what's cool. That's what I like about this. Everyone gets to be a part of it, you know. My grandparents and parents and in-laws, everyone will get to come. And everyone's an Ohio State fan, so gives them a reason to come to the game, too.
This is sometimes a silly question, but do you have a memory or two that really stand out when you look back at your Ohio State career?
It's tough to pick, like, one or two. I mean, my whole senior year was an amazing memory. Just I think as I get older, I look at it, I think of how special it was, all the guys, how well we all got along. Like, we're still, our kids play together. Bobby and Schlegel, like, we don't live that far from each other. Our kids play together all the time. I see them a lot. Like, I guess at the time, we never thought of, like, oh, this is going to be lifelong friendships, and our kids are going to play together, and we still hang out a lot. I never thought of that. And now I realize, too, as I get older, how special that is. I mean, not everybody has that. Not every class has that. Not every school has that. So I think just the whole everything, the people, just amazing. But as far as, like, in-game action, there's no one or two plays I could point to that stick out.
Is there a certain game that you often play in your head?
I mean, some of the losses, yeah. I mean, those are the ones that you think of. Yeah, I mean, Texas game my senior year. It would have been nice to win that. Penn State my senior year would have been nice to win that.
Not better at all, are you?
No, they're a good team. Texas had a good squad. Vince Young was good. They had a ton of talent. Yeah, so it happens. Yeah. I'm not bitter, but yeah, I mean, you don't get over it. You don't get over the losses. I'm sure Coach Trestle isn't either. No, he's going to be here tonight, supposedly. So, yeah. Ryan, I'd like to have that one back.
Ryan Day said he really wants to make an emphasis on recruiting the state of Ohio. Why is that important?
I mean, I think when Ohio is such a huge high school football state, obviously people here just want to win. People that live in Ohio, they want Ohio State to win. I think that gives you the best chance. You have a good core group of Ohio guys. You don't have to overreach if it's not a class that has a ton of Ohio talent that you feel like should come here. Then you don't have to, but I think it's smart. I think anytime it's Ohio, Texas, Florida, if you're in those states, why aren't you? You should absolutely recruit hard. You feel like if you have guys that are top-tier talent, you don't want them to leave the state. You don't want them to leave. And I think when Ohio State is playing its best, that's what a lot of times happens. And I think he hit the ground running when it comes to recruiting. And, yeah, why wouldn't you? I think when you're lucky enough to live or to coach in this state, you're going to have a ton of talent to choose from. You don't want any of those guys leaving.
He's also talked about wanting to make sure former players from whenever feel welcome. I don't know how much you've interacted with him or been around the program recently, but is that message getting across to guys that, hey, you're welcome at the program whenever?
Yeah, it has to me, at least. I've been around Coach Day a decent amount of times and gotten to speak with him at length a few times. He's awesome. I'm very impressed by everything about him, his message, how clear and concise it is, and how confident he is in what he's doing. He's not trying to be Chip Kelly. He's not trying to be Urban Meyer. He knows what his plan is, and he's going to go forward with it. I respect that. And it's easy to do. It's easy once you get the head coaching job somewhere to try to hold on tight and not lose it. I don't think he has that at all. I think he's going out there and trying to put his guys in position to make plays, and he's made some good hires. And I think when you talk to the players, too, they love him. They love playing for the guy. So I think he's done all the things right. Now you just can't lose any football games.
Easy enough. So after you attain some fame in the NFL, et cetera,